Let us now discuss how transistor can be used as an amplifier. We already discussed in output characteristics of common emitter and common base connections. Of a transistor that in active region, you can recall that active region was the one when base emitter junction is forward biased and collector junction is reverse biased. We have discussed that in active region, small variation in input current to transistor causes large variation in output current. You can just recall the shape of output characteristic in which if we just change the input current, then output current suddenly changes to another value which is much higher than the previous value. And we can say due to this property only, the property we are talking about, that a small variation in input current causes large variation in output current, we can say due to this property, transistor can be used as an amplifier. Because this is the characteristic of a transistor which we are going to study in detail about how due to this property amplification action can be understood for a transistor, and we can also write on the basis of different connections of a transistor, it can be used as an amplifier in three ways. These three kind of amplifiers are called based on the type of connections, that is common base amplifier, another one is common emitter amplifier, and the last one is common collector amplifier. As we already discussed that common collector configuration of a transistor is out of the scope of these lectures. That's why here in upcoming sections, we are going to discuss about common base and common emitter amplifiers. For these lectures, we are limiting up to this level only. We are not going to discuss in detail about common collector amplifier. In general, a student can keep in mind that in common collector amplifier, collector terminal is taken as a common terminal to input as well as output terminals. Let's continue in the coming sections in detail about common base and common emitter amplifiers.